Hello friends, in the previous lecture we discussed triboelectric series, charge, electric field, the space surrounding a charge, electric field line. The triboelectric series is a list of material that ranks according to their tendency to gain or lose electron. The material which donates electron are listed on the top and the electron receiver are listed at the bottom. Ebonite was listed at the bottom. Due to gain or lose electron, object get charged. Charge is the property of any material by virtue of which it apply electrostatic force of interaction on other object. Later we discussed Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law says the force of attraction or repulsion between two charges are directly proportional to the product of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. Later we discussed about the space surrounding a charge called electric field. Electric field line indicates the direction of electric field vector. The line of force are purely a geometrical construction which helps us to visualize the nature of electric field in the region. Actually, they have no physical existence. They are hypothetical or imaginary. Now we will see what is an electric potential energy. Electric potential energy. Electric potential energy is the amount of work done to bring unit positive charge from infinite to a certain point within an electric field. Suppose there is a charge, say Q1, and this is the electric field of this charge. Now another charge, Q2. Q2 is a unit positive charge. So the amount of work done to bring this charge from infinite to certain point within an electric field is called electric potential energy. Q1 is fixed and Q2 is at infinite. So the amount of work done to bring this unit positive charge from infinite to a certain point within an electric field is called electric potential energy. And the amount of work done to bring this unit positive charge from one place to another place within the electric field is called electric potential difference. Now, electric potential at any point is equal to work done per positive charge in carrying it from infinite to that point in electric field. It is negative of the work done by the electric force of the configuration of system. Now, consider a system of two charges. Consider the system of two charges. Charge Q1 is situated at point A and charge Q2 was initially at point B. Now we are starting moving this Q2 charge and for an instance the position of this Q2 charge is here and we will have to move this charge up to C. Suppose the distance from A to B was R1 and distance from A to C, R2, the distance from initial position Q1 and the position of charge at an instance is Q, so the distance is R and this is a small distance dr. So considering that system of two charges, Q1 is fixed at point A and the charge Q2 is taken from a point B to point C along the line of ABC. Now, F will be the force of attraction or repulsion. F will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. And which direction? The direction will be AB direction. AB direction. Therefore, the work done by the force in a small displacement dr will be dw equal to f dr. Now we want to get the work done to bring this charge from infinite to a certain point in the electric field to point B. So we will integrate it. So total work done will be integration of dW. That will be equal to how much? And we will integrate it from R1 to R2. So it will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square dr. We'll take out the constant value. So it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2. Now R1 R2. So 1 by R square is variable, so it will be integrated. Again, this value comes Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 1 by R R1 R2. That will equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Work done by the electric force on Q1 charge is 0 as it is kept fixed. Therefore, the charge in potential energy V will be equal to VR2 minus VR1, that will be equal to negative of the work done W. So we can write V equal to VR1 minus VR2. That will be equal to, VR2 minus VR1. That will be equal to negative of the work done, that is equal to minus W. Therefore, we can write W is equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 1 by 4 1 by R R1 minus 1 by R2. Therefore, minus of Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So, if you put negative sign inside the bracket, it will be equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0, it will be inverted, so 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. We choose the potential energy of the two charge system to be 0 when they have infinite separation. This means V infinite will be equal to 0. Therefore, we can write V equal to VR only minus V infinite. V infinite equal to 0. So, V will be equal to how much? VR minus V infinite. So it will be equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 V1 R2 is here VR. So it will be 1 by R only minus 1 by infinite. So 1 by infinite will be equal to 0. So it will be Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 1 by R. So finally, we can write इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इक्वल टू 1 बाय 4 पाई एप्सिलॉन 0 q1 q2 बाय r। Here, the electrostatic force acting per unit positive charge on a point in electric field is called electric field intensity at that point. Now, we'll discuss electric field intensity. What is electric field intensity? Electric field intensity is the electrostatic force acting per unit positive charge on a point in electric field. Now, electric field intensity. The electric field, electrostatic force acting per unit positive charge on a point in electric field is called electric field intensity at that point. Write down the electrostatic force acting the electrostatic force acting per unit positive charge on a point is electric field
intensity.
If we take q1 equal to q and q2 equal to 1, q1 equal to q and q2 equal to 1, then we will have the electric field intensity will be equal to
the force
acting. So E will be equal to, so electric field intensity E will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, and we will put the value in the previous value we obtained. So it will be E will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 by r, and here q1 is capital Q and q2 is unity 1, so it will come how much, 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q into 1 by r, then it will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r. Finally, electric field intensity will be equal to E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r square. If a charge q experiences an electric force f, we define the intensity of electric field at that point, that given point will be E equal to F by Q or minus V by R. So we'll omit it. Or minus V by R. The electric field due to a set of charge may be obtained by finding the field due to each individual charge and then adding this field according to the rule of vector addition. So, according to vector addition, if two components supposed to be E1, electric field intensity of one component is E1 and other component is E2, so final total electric field will be equal to root under E1 square plus E2 square. So, now electric dipole. A combination of two opposite charges separated by a small distance constitute an electric dipole. Suppose two charges opposite charge. These two charges are very small and they are separated by small distance T. Then the electric dipole moment of the combination will be P equal to QD. Now will see how to calculate the electric potential energy due to this dipole and electric potential intensity due to this dipole at a point. Now we will calculate electric potential energy due to a dipole at certain point, and also we will calculate electric field intensity due to this dipole at certain point. Now first of all, electric potential energy due to a dipole at a certain point. Let us suppose a dipole and the distance between the dipole r, suppose 2L. We will take 2L, we can take d also, but if we will take 2L, the calculation will be easier. Suppose this is the point, it is the axis, and we have to calculate the electric dipole, the potential electric potential energy due to this dipole at point P, making an angle theta. Situated at the distance between this point and the axis of the pole, dipole is r, suppose. So we'll join these two. Now we'll do a construction. We will extend, this is suppose A and this is B. So we will extend PO further and draw a perpendicular line AM, and here also BN. Now we'll have to calculate electric potential due to this dipole. So we'll calculate one by one electric potential due to this charge here and due to this charge, and then what we'll do, we will add up. So first of all, we'll calculate this distance, AP distance. Distance AP is approximately equal to PM, and we can write PM equal to PO plus OM. PO is R, and plus this angle is theta, so this angle will be also theta, so this side will be 2L, L cos theta. Since this side is L theta, so we will take cos theta, and so it will be L cos theta. So it will be R plus OM will be L cos theta. In the same way, if we calculate BP, it is approximately equal to PN, that is PO minus ON, that is equal to R minus L cos theta, in the same way. Now electric due to minus Q at P, suppose it is V1, so that will be equal to how much? It will be one by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by, this is minus, we will put minus here, minus Q charge by distance is AP. So AP, so it will be equal to minus Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 into this R plus L cos theta. In the same way, electric potential due to P plus q at t will be how much? V2 will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by instead of Vp it will be Vp, that will equal to q by 4 pi epsilon 0 r minus l cos theta. Now the total electric potential due to this dipole will be the electric potential due to this minus charge due to this charge. So V will be equal to the total will be equal to say total electric potential is V, then V will be equal to V1 plus V2, that is V1 is minus Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R plus L cos theta and plus charge 4 pi epsilon 0 R minus L cos theta. Now add up, it will be q by 4 pi epsilon 0 into 1 by, since this is minus and this is plus, so we'll invert it, so 1 by r minus l cos theta minus 1 by r plus l cos theta. So it will be equal to q by r minus l cos theta, it will be equal to q by 4 pi epsilon 0, and here we will take LCM, so LCM will be r square minus L square cos square theta, A plus B into A minus B. So it will be A plus B into A minus B, A square minus B square. So in the same way, so we will divide R minus L cos theta will be R plus L cos theta, and it will be this minus sign. So R minus R plus, so minus R plus L cos theta. So this R will be cancelled. It will be equal to q by 4 pi epsilon 0 into 2 L cos theta by R square minus L square cos square theta. This is equal to 2-1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 2QL cos theta by r square, since r square is very very greater than l square cos square theta. Finally, electric potential energy due to this dipole will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. Instead of this 2ql, we will write dipole moment. A while ago we calculated the combination of two charges, opposite charges separated by a small distance, consider dipole, and the electric dipole moment of this combination will be equal to P equal to Q into D, and instead of D we used 2L, so P equal to 2QL, so this 2QL we can replace it by P, it will be P cos theta by r square. So this is the dipole moment, electric potential energy due to a dipole. Let us consider two charges constitute a dipole. Suppose we have to calculate electric field intensity at this point P. P situated at a distance of R from the axis of the dipole, making an angle theta. This distance is R. Suppose the resultant intensity, electric field intensity, is in this direction. So small distance, this is R. So this is P1, so a small distance dr. This is a small distance. This is P2. So this is a small distance, angle d theta. So this angle, this side will be, this small side will be r d theta. I will give this fresh picture here. Now we'll calculate electric field intensity due to this dipole. So what we'll have to do, we'll calculate electric field intensity this side, this ER, and this side E theta, and then we'll combine it, we'll add up, so it will be a vector addition. So first of all we'll calculate E theta, ER. So ER will be equal to how much? Minus dV by dr, and it is equal to electric potential due to this dipole. We calculated how much? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P into cos theta by r square. So it will be minus d by dr 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P cos theta by r square. That will be equal to, we will write small. So take out the constants, will be minus P cos theta is constant, so we will take out 4 pi r, 4 pi epsilon 0 is a constant, so it will be d 1 by r square by dr. If you differentiate, how much it will be? Minus 2 by r cube. So it will be equal to total p cos theta minus, and the minus will be plus, into by 4 pi r square, 4 pi epsilon 0 into 2 by r cube. That means er equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into 2p cos theta by r cube. So this is equation first. Now we will calculate ER, this ER, electric field intensity at theta direction. So it will be again, E theta will be minus dv by r d theta. So dv, v again, v is equal to, this is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 p cos theta by r square. So it will be minus d by r d theta into 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 p cos theta by r square. Now this time theta is variable, so we will take out rest outside, so it will be minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. This r and is r square will be r cube p by r cube d cos theta by d theta. And this if you differentiate cos theta, that will be minus sin theta. So minus and minus, this will be plus. It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 p sin theta by r cube. This is equation second. Now if you add this er and this e theta, you will get total electric field intensity at point P at a direction alpha, say. So we'll calculate e total electric field intensity. Suppose it is E, then it will be root under we'll do vector addition, because these two are vector quantity. So it will be E r square plus E theta square. It will be equal to E r from equation first. It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into 2 P cos theta by r cube square plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into p sin theta by r cube square, whole square. Now again calculate, we'll take out 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 and p and r cube, we take out from the root. So it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 p by r cube. It can be taken out from the root, so rest will be root under 2 cos theta whole square plus sin square theta, or sin square, sin theta whole square will be okay. Now if you calculate, it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P by R cube, it will be 4 cos square theta plus sin square theta. We can write 1 plus cos square theta instead of sin square theta. So 1 plus cos square theta. Now total will be again right 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P by R cube. So root under, it will be 4 cos square theta and it will be minus. This is minus. Okay. Now this will be 3 cos square theta. Now equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P by R cube. Root under this 4 cos square theta and minus cos square theta, it will be 3 cos square theta plus 1. So finally the total electric field intensity E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P root under 3 cos square theta plus 1 by R cube. And of course we will calculate the direction. So how we will calculate the direction? With the tan alpha. So tan alpha will be tan perpendicular by base. So this is perpendicular this direction. So e theta by e r. So e theta is how much? E theta we calculated here. So e theta is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P sin theta by R cube by E r. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 2 P cos theta by R square. So this and this will be cancelled. P and P will be cancelled. R and R will be cancelled. So it will be
total 10 theta by 2 or alpha equal to 10 inverse 10 theta by 2.
We calculated electric field intensity due to a dipole at a point P at angle theta. In this, we also calculated the electric potential energy at point P at angle theta. What if theta is 0? So it will be called axial position. What if this theta is 90 degree? Then it will be called equatorial position. So we will see, omitting this.
If theta equal to 0 degree, this is called axial position. So in this situation, in this case, electric potential energy will be how much? It will be, actually we know, V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P cos theta by R square. So, if here, if theta is 0, then it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 cos theta, cos 0 will be 1. So, it will be P by R square. And E, calculate electric field intensity. Electric field intensity is how much? We calculate E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P by R cube root under.
If we put theta equal to 0, then it will be
1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P by R cube. This cos theta will be 0, then cos square theta will be 1, then it will be 3 plus 1, 4, that will be 2, and this will be 2.
Now, equatorial position, what if
theta is 90 degree?
This position is called equatorial position.
Then in the same way, V will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, and this theta is 90 degree, so cos 90 is 0, so it will be 0 and total will be 0. In the same way, E, electric field intensity at 90 degree or equatorial position, it will be, if you put 90 degree, then it will be the cos 90, 0, 0 plus 1, 1, then the final value will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P by R cube.
Thank you for watching.